As Dr. Saab, as people in politics, we have to stand up where we see people's civil liberties being oppressed. One of the civil liberties is I want to drive on the boulevard. Your chief minister drives on Srinagar, the boulevard is closed. Zubin Mehta comes to Srinagar, the boulevard is closed. Stop closing our roads.
How do you accept
the roads belong to us?
I understand.
It does not belong to the National Conference. It does not belong to the German embassy.
Matu Saab.
The entire conversation of yours, you have not condemned
the opposition made by the terrorist outfits of this music concern. I want a person like you, an educated person like you, to condemn what the separatist groups have reacted to this musical concert, and then give reasons of why it's not open to the public. When you create a fear on the streets, when you create a terror on the streets, how do you expect the government to open it to the public?
I told you I'm not conspiratorial.
Mr. Pandit, just separating the points here.
I told you I'm not conspiratorial about it. I just told you why exactly. My civil liberties and rights be put into abeyance
because,
for 2 days.
Because there are people...
Or if I'll bring Zubin Mehta to play and you can't move...
Because Mr. Junaid Mattu, there are people sitting right... There are other people, like the people sitting next to you, who are fomenting trouble in the valley, who are striking fear among the life of the people. Does not have checks, then you only tomorrow will turn around and say, what has this government done to safeguard us, safeguard the civilians and their lives and property? So you can't swing both ways and strike the plate from both sides. You can't do that. You can't do that.
Can I interject here, please, kindly?
Elite guests. It's putting
yes, Ms. Zila Khan.
Safeguard its guests, not the Kashmiri. A Kashmiri.
One second, Mr. Mattu. Yes, Ms. Khan.
Well, what I have to say is that. What I have to say is that we all completely understand how difficult it is when the barricades are done and roads are closed. We completely understand that, and I am with you on this, and I appreciate what you are saying for
Thank
Kashmiris
you.
And for all the roads everywhere for the way it is done. But we must understand, please, one thing, that at least it's a start that there is a slight platform of a cultural, a musical, international, beautiful aspect, a concert. They are having to barricade lots of roads and whatever because of the past so many threats that the German ambassador has got. And hats off to him that he is being able to ground.
I understand that it is very discomforting
for the barricades. When there is shooting and firing done, that is the barricade that also that we should think about. That those barricades, those are the reasons where we should not have those reasons.
The hypocrisy with this separatist group is they allow Junoon.
So obviously, because of that, there is a chain.
The hypocrisy is that they allow Junoon, a Pakistani band, to come in Kashmir and play.
I would like to say that even I had a concert in Kashmir Valley about a few months back.
I had a Sufi music concert
in Kashmir, in Srinagar, a few months back. And so again, though there was no barricading, there was no stoppage of any roads, but hardly anybody had the gumption or the guts to come for such an event, because it is again, but we have to keep trying for this, for some peace and beauty for the Kashmiri lives also, after all, people and households, households actually deserve a better and more beautiful culture rather than just barricades because of fighting.
Believe me, every Kashmiri in Kashmir on the streets want absolute peace. They don't want the firing, the noises of the gun and the blast to happen in Kashmir. They want violence to be played there. They want music to be played there. Nobody's interested in this. And the problem with this separatist group is they are losing ground on the valley.
They are losing power in the valley. And whenever this incident happens, whenever other Indian concerts happen, how many Kashmiris are allowed to come out for those Sufi concerts?
They try to make their felt. That the presence felt in Kashmir because they are losing ground with common people. They are losing ground on the ground level as far as the support of Kashmiris are concerned.
The common people and deserve better. They deserve to have some beauty in their lives.
And it's commendable.
And music
that
is
Umar
beautiful.
Abdullah, the CM, has taken
whether it is Zubin Mehta or it is
organizing this show in Kashmir. It's commendable on behalf of CM Umar Abdullah to stand by this entire show and give a message to the world that Kashmir needs peace, Kashmir is non-violent, and Kashmir is full of romance. Kashmir is full of music. We have fantastic musicians in Kashmir. We have fantastic
that
singers in Kashmir.
That is the kind of Kashmir we want to see and we want
from,
to showcase
from
to the world
Sufism
and we want
birth,
to have
has taken birth in
for the Kashmiri people. Not just to show
who
in the world, but even for
the
Kashmiri people.
Mind can have a problem with this.
Basic human rights are violated. Fundamental rights are violated.
Who has violated?
Why?
You have violated. You have violated the fundamental rights of Kashmiri.
This is a failed argument.
Mr.
Khan, this would be a failed argument. This is going to go against you. Who has violated those human rights?
It's government of India.
How
what
can
government of India who killed more
Mr.
than 100
Mr. Naeem Khan, who called for a band? Who is threatening the people not to attend the concert? Who is threatening the people to boycott this entire concert in Kashmir? It is the separatists, and how can you say it's the government of India that's causing problem in Kashmir? How can you make these statements? You are not allowing your own brand of musicians to prosper, but you are ready to welcome a Pakistani band there in Kashmir. How can you have double standards like that? How can you have double standards and how can you sit here and say that what you're saying is right?
It's a duty of Indian government to protect its area. It's a duty of the Indian government. You stop killing people. You stop firing on the streets. You stop blasting in Kashmir. And Indian government will not behave like this.
I agree with this because...
Why the civil society people, why the people of Kashmir, why not given permission to hold a Haqeeqat Kashmir concert in Kashmir?
Hakikat Kashmir, you sing anti-national songs. You sing anti-national songs. You sing anti-human songs, and government of India will allow you to say anti-national songs.
Mr. Naeem Khan, Kashmir is an integral part of India, and it has been ceded since 1974. It has been agreed by unanimously by the Kashmir Assembly. And what you are doing in your concerts is anti-national propaganda, and that should not be allowed. That should not be tolerated. As for Mr. Junaid Mattu, when your own people are stopping Kashmir local talent. What happened to the band Prakash? What happened to the band Prakash? Why didn't you speak up when they were banned? Why didn't you speak up when they were banned? When people like Mr. Naeem Khan were standing there and objecting to their performance, why didn't you speak up then?
How are you sure I didn't speak up?
So if you did, then you should not object to this concert. Because what you have to focus on is not the 1,500 people who will be standing, who will be there live on ground. What you have to focus on is the entire world, more than billions of people who will watch this concert being conducted successfully in Kashmir. That is what should be more important for you. That is the message that you got to send to the world, that you should come to Kashmir. It is a safe haven. People love other people. That's what
you
should focus on.
Let me talk.
Go ahead.
You, first of all, you're a news anchor. Don't tell me what you should focus on. Neither are you my...
You also don't tell me what we should talk about because we know what we are doing. So you don't get personal here, Mr. Junaid Mattu. Stick to the issue.
I'm not telling you what you should talk about. That is your own brand of...
So don't get personal. Stick to the issue. I'm talking about the issue.
We unequivocally stand up for justice, fairness, the upholding of rights and liberties. And we don't look at it on a political prism. But if you're telling me why didn't you stand up for that, do your
homework. And classical music is not liberal?
We stand up unequivocally and unconditionally. Ma'am, are you listening to what I'm saying? Or have you decided that all Kashmiris are rabid people who are...
Nobody's saying that.
Nobody's saying that.
Don't go on a sympathy wave.
I'm being
don't become a martyr. Nobody's saying that.
All I'm saying...
Nobody is saying
all
that, Mr. Matu.
No, Ashok sir, it's your habit of becoming a martyr in exile. I'm not a martyr.
You're trying to create a sympathy for yourself.
Very reasonably, nothing against the concert. Two thumbs up, nothing against the concerts. All the best to Zubin Mehta. He's a great figure. It's a privilege. But why should I compromise and sacrifice my civil liberties, have people as if they're in war gear standing on our bridges and on our roads, terrorizing us as if we're all potential
Matu
terrorists?
Matu sahab, who's responsible for that? Who's responsible? The gentleman sitting beside you. The gentleman sitting beside you is responsible. Tomorrow, if anything happens to Zubin Mehta, who will be responsible?
A lot of people. And out of them are those two who will be sitting in the front rows of tomorrow's concerts. They too are. Their cuffs smell of blood. They too are responsible for this oppression. They have put a moral baggage on an ordinary Indian. They have oppressed their own people, killed their own people.
Mr. Matu, this is an election manifesto.
But why humiliate?
Don't allow him to do it. This is an election manifesto.
Absolutely.
Yes, exactly, Dr. Baig. Go ahead. Speak up, Dr. Baig. Speak up, Dr. Baig.
Dr. Baig, the first point that Junaid Matu made, the first point that he made, why have such an elitist program? If we were to ignore, just, you know, for argument's sake, the point that you are making, the first point that he made, I think it holds true.
So, it's a choice of the government.
The more you drag such an event into mud pond of politics, this is what will happen. That's unfortunate. Is it something obscene? No. Nobody would do it. But the more you bring it into what you call as mud pond of politics, the more it will happen. This is a state which has been, we have gone through hell. We have seen militancy, we have seen guns roaring from all over, and it hasn't stopped completely as yet.
All the more reason, sir. All the more reason, Khan sahab.
You have to take some.
All the more reason for you to accept music. And to highlight the peacefulness of your place. All the more reason for that.
I'm not against
that. And we are trying to do that, but I wish you would also want to do it.
Whom are you addressing to?
No, we've got to tell Zila Khan that was Dr. Mehboob Beg from the National Conference speaking. But the message that's going out is to Mr. Naeem Khan. Yes, Dr. Beg, you had a point to make. Go ahead, please. You are saying something, Dr. Baig, complete.
No, what I am saying is, it should have been perceived as a cultural event, as a great event, a musical event, and nothing to do with politics. Because there are people who want to drag it, such an aesthetic event, into mud pond of politics. That's why it's happening. Now, why we are taking security precautions, it has become all the more important. We can't take a risk of having seen any threat to this great event. So we have to take all the measures that nothing untoward happens. Nothing more, nothing beyond that.
Even today, everything was peaceful, in spite of the fact that there was a hartal call. It's your government saying that there is no militancy. But why such type of drill, military drill in the roads in Chennai? Why?
No, Khan sahab, it has come down, but it is not absolutely out. We are not out of the turmoil.
But the people are against this.
No, absolute. No, but that's what I was saying. Let's leave it to their judgment.
Actually, the music is of a very high caliber. Absolutely. We are talking about Western classical music. We are talking about people. We are talking about composers who are of equal caliber of Kalidas and Lal Dev. And Hazrat Sheikh Nuruddin,
and also Ghalib,
so you should not say such kind of music.
Exactly,
it is not a small
exactly,
kind
Ms.
of
Khan.
Music.